Hi there, this is Joy with snazzydrawers.com. I develop craft tutorials on my website, and I just wanted to show you today how to make a headband from stretch elastic lace for children of all ages. Before I started making headbands, I was really curious how people would make an embellishment and attach it to a headband and hide all of the ugliness behind the embellishment, such as a fabric flower or a felt flower or all of the multiple different kinds of embellishments you can attach to a headband. And that's exactly what I'm going to show you today. It's extremely simple, very easy to do, and the possibilities are endless. These are great for gift giving, newborn, baby gifts, shower gifts, you name it. Lots of possibilities here. Just to get started, I first cut out my elastic. You have two options here. You can either look at the elastic chart that Snazzy Drawers has given you here. Just in time. Or you can also measure your child's head if you have that option. Sometimes you don't have your child on hand and you would like to make this while they're at school or etc. But if you would like to do that and you do have them on hand, take your measuring tape and wrap it around their head where the actual headband would go. Then take that measurement, subtract 1.5 inches, and that will be the measurement you will need for your elastic. I am personally going to make this for my niece. She is almost 5 years old and we are going to make it 15.5 inches. So I have pre-cut my elastic lace 15.5 inches, as you can see here. And first thing you need to know about stretch elastic is that it has two sides. One side is the ugly side that shows the elastic, and one side is the pretty side. And we're going to call the pretty side, the side that you want to see wrapped around your child's head, the right side. The other side will be considered the wrong side. So what you need to do is you need to take your right sides, the pretty sides, touch them after you've folded the lace in half lengthwise. So touch your pretty sides together, facing together, the right sides together. And then on one end, we're going to stitch those together. You need to thread your needle using coordinating thread. I'm using contrasting thread just for illustrative purposes. So take your elastic where those two ends are touching, and you're going to stitch those together approximately about 1/8 of an inch from the end. This is just approximate. And first I'm just going to pull my needle through those two layers. And we're going to stitch back and forth all the way across there. So stitch back and forth, pulling really tight. Anyway, so keep doing that. You want to go back and forth a few times. This is actually going to be hidden. No one's ever going to see this, so it does not have to look perfect. The main thing here is you want this to be secured together well, so that these don't come undone, because you don't want, the last thing you want is to spend an enormous amount of time on the embellishment that's going to go on here in the elastic to come undone. And for all practical purposes, it to not be wearable for your gift recipient or your child. So I'm just going to continue doing that a few times. Make sure you're pulling both your thread all the way through. Okay, and then the best way to see it if it's tight enough, it's just to pull on your elastic. If it doesn't come undone, which mine doesn't, then you're done. Great. So So then just tie a knot, your preferred knot. Whoops, sometimes your elastic gets away from you. Or curls up. If you do find that your elastic is curling up, great way to fix that, just found today, after I've been battling this problem for months, is to just get out your iron and steam it some and press it. And that really takes a lot of the curl out of your elastic, especially if you've washed it or dyed it. You can also dye your elastic. Lots of great tutorials on that if you just want to buy white and dye it a million colors. And again, you can find on my blog some links to my preferred suppliers that sell basically at wholesale cost. Okay, so I'm finished here. So you cut that off and open it up so that your right sides are facing out, your pretty sides, and plug in your hot glue gun. Or you can also use a fast drying glue. I also like Eileen's Fast Grab glue is a great one too. I'm going to take an embellishment, which is a flower using my Audrey pattern from my website, snazzydrawers.com. I'm going to take this embellishment and adhere it with hot glue to cover up where I just stitched. So basically, turn over your embellishment. And we're actually going to put glue all around the underneath ugly side of your embellishment. Place your elastic in the middle, covering that up, and I have pre-cut a piece of felt and I'm just going to simply push it down onto the glue. Voila, you are done. Can you believe how easy that is? And you have a nice finished completed flower. You may have to pull away some of the strings from the glue because you definitely do not want to have glue showing when you gift these. And you can also stitch an X and an O for hearts and kisses, or your put a label here if you're selling these. You can also add just some personal touches here, since only the recipient will see that, and it's just kind of a nice way to add a personal touch. We are finished with our headband.